PSP Audioware has just released their Hertz Rider 2 plugin. In this review, I will show you how it sounds and I will show you a few examples how you can use it to get better mixes. Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. The Hertz Rider 2 is a frequency pitch shifter, so it pitch shifts frequencies. But not in a traditional way a pitch shifter works by pitching everything, but according to the root frequency and its harmonics. It shifts the tonality within a sound and you create interesting effects with it or use it for useful frequency fixing. Let's go over the controls and I will let you hear how the Hertz Rider sounds. You set the pitch shift with these dials. The plugin can work as a mono, stereo linked and dual mono frequency shift plugin. You can link the channels here. Unlink them and choose from two different styles of linking. Over here you set the range where the shifting is active. Regard it as a bandwidth regulator with 1K being the smallest and 10K being the most extreme. If you unlink the stereo switch and set both left and right channel to different settings, it will widen your stereo image. Be careful with how you set the shift or material with tuned audio like this synth. It can easily sound out of tune. Well, unless you after that effect. Add a high pass filter afterwards to have better mono compatibility. On, for instance, a solo snare, this frequency shifting in mono can be very useful to fix a snare's tuning. This sample has the wrong pitch to fit nicely in this mix, and this makes mixing more difficult. With Hertz Rider, you just simply shift the frequencies until you hear when the snare fits nicely in this mix. And you can continue mixing from here. This will save you a lot of headache. There's an LFO section, which can be synced to the tempo of the project. And you have different types of LFOs. The rate changes the speed. Depth is how much modulation of the LFO is happening. And spread is how much of the LFO modulation is spread between the two stereo channels. This can also widen your stereo image and you can go from wacky sweeps to more subtle enhancement for movement in a sound. This is the envelope filter. With the envelope filter, it's really easy to get auto envelope type effects. Let's demonstrate on this bass synth. I have set up Hertz Rider as a send effect and automated the send level of the synth to the Hertz Rider. The envelope reacts to the incoming volume. As you can hear, the envelope effect can be done really easily and sounds different than done with, for instance, the Denise Audio The Sweeper. A link to that review is in the description below. If you want to tweak the behavior of the envelope of Hertz Rider, the plugin has a few controls for that. There's Threshold, which is your baseline above which the envelope reacts, a dial called Time, and a dial called Mod. These last two work together, and with these two you set the attack, release or a combined attack release time with the Time dial. And if you add a form of distortion or saturation after the Hertz Rider, you get even more fun. Now, you can also use the PSP Hertzrider as an excellent drum mix fixer and a drum fattener. I felt that was an entire video on its own, and I will cover that in another video. By the time it's released, it will be linked here. Please subscribe to this channel and like this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!